On January 13th, 2012, a Carnival cruise ship had capsized off the coast of Italy, and on January 14th, we were able to see the full extent of what had happened. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the story of the Costa Concordia. Welcome to Critical Navigation. I'm your host, Andrew, and with me today is Aiden from Extreme Dubstep.
Thanks for having me, Andrew, and I hope y'all are all having a fantastic day. So, the Costa Concordia was owned by Carnival Cruise Lines. The ship was ordered in 2004, and construction started on November 8, 2004. Construction ended on June 30, 2006, at the staggering cost of $570 million.
She was 952 feet long. She had a beam of 116 feet and 13 decks, which at the time made her the largest ship in the Costa fleet. She could go 23 knots an hour and was one of the nicest ships in her time.
She literally had everything. Movie theaters, four pools, five restaurants, 13 bars, a two-story spa, and even featured an outdoor movie screen out on the center pool. There was a slide out on the family pool, and one of the most striking features of this ship was the grand atrium that had shown 10 stories.
She was truly one of the nicest ships ever built. She had 1,502 guest cabins, 601 crew cabins, which meant she could carry 4,890 people. The captain was Francesco Scatino, however, she would sail on her last journey in 2012. Ladies and gentlemen, let's take a look at the sinking of the Costa Concordia.
The Costa Concordia had set sail from Cagliari on January 11, 2012. After she had stopped in Sicily Shay, she made her way to Civitavecchia, Italy on Friday the 13th, 2012. Night had fallen and the ship had sailed to Sifona. This course would take her right in the middle of the island of Gigolo and Italy's mainland.
Although the Costa Concordia was going to be taking part in what is known as a sail-by salute, where they would sail really close to the island they were passing. This is still done today, but very carefully, because this is what would seal the Costa Concordia's fate.
As day became night, the Costa Concordia was getting closer and closer to the island, and at 9:40 p.m., it was almost completely dark. The safest distance for the Concordia to get to the island was about 1,500 feet. The ship was heading straight for the island, and the ship was about to make its turn, although there was a big problem.
There was a miscommunication about the course, and somehow the ship was actually 659 meters closer to the island than it should have been. The ship was way too close to the island, and the captain ordered the ship to start turning to the right. Although at 9:44, the ship had ran into some underwater rocks and now had a huge gash in the side of the ship.
The Costa Concordia had completely lost power, but when the backup generators had kicked in, an announcement was made around 9:51 p.m. that it was only a blackout at the time and everything was under control. At 10:07 p.m., compartments 4, 5, 6, and 7 had been filled and the ship had started to list.
Passengers inside of the ship had started to make their way to the lifeboats, and the captain had made the decision to let the ship drift into shallow water. The situation had gotten so bad that at 10:35, there was an announcement to abandon ship.
All of the passengers had made their way to deck 4 to board the lifeboats. The ship had been listing so badly that some of the lifeboats weren't even being launched and around 80 people were still on the ship. They had to climb onto the side of the ship and get down with a rope ladder.
Although the captain had already gotten off of the ship and was on the shore, the Coast Guard had asked him to return to the vessel, although he didn't. Anyone who was still on the ship was being rescued, and when the morning came, we could now see the full extent of what had happened.
On the side of the ship, you could see a huge gash that had sealed Concordia's fate. Since the ship had listed so much, three of the lifeboats were completely unable to be launched, and 32 passengers had died that day, and some of the bodies had been found in the elevators. I can't even begin to imagine being trapped in a dark elevator while it slowly filled with water and you just drowned to death. The ship was at a total loss, and there was completely no hope of saving it now. Plans had been made to move the ship, and 1 year later after the sinking, on September 13th, 2013, the ship had been raised.
It is truly incredible how only 1 year changed the ship so much. The ship had been refloated, and she had made her final journey on July 14th of 2013. The ship had gone through a major gutting process, and they began scrapping what was left of the Costa Concordia. And that, my friends, is the story of the Costa Concordia. Thank you so much for watching today's video, and I want to thank Aiden for being here today.
I'd like to thank you for letting me be in this video today, Andrew, because I'm always very grateful to be in them, and I always love recording the audio for them, and I hope everyone else likes your videos too.
Well, everyone, thank you so much for watching today's video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you want to see some more awesome videos, please subscribe, and we'll see you next time when we look at Flight 243. Until then, I'm your host, Andrew, signing out.